I'm just trying to manifest a successful Etsy shop and live my childhood dreams of becoming an artist. Universe, let's make this happen. Hey everyone, my name is Afra. Welcome to my channel. In this video, we are doing studio vlog one. That's right, 01 this way. Yes, 01. It is the first studio vlog to be on this channel and I'm excited because we are about to get crafty. So before I get into this, I just want to say I have had a lot of failed attempts at trying to come up with like a creative side hustle or side income to fulfill my soul without making capitalism angry at me. So in high school, I actually had an Etsy shop and I did like handmade woven jewelry and like added charms on it and it did not look good. And yeah, that failed. No one bought it. And yeah, I don't have any evidence to show you because I threw everything away because I was a very angsty teenager. So that was fail one. And then later in college, I actually made purses. That's right, I made purses. And I would buy like faux leather from Joann's Fabric and cut it up and use fabric glue of all things to make a purse. And it was obviously not sturdy. And yeah, it takes real craftsmanship to make a purse. So that failed too. And then a couple months ago, actually, it's been a year now. I tried doing embroidery and I thought that would be like my thing and I just kind of lost interest in it. So yeah, here we are. So outside of my creative pursuits, I've always found that life's confusion and weirdness can always be resolved or like the answers are in your inner child. So for me and my inner child as a kid, I actually always loved drawing and art and I wasn't like a technical good drawer. Like I couldn't draw faces or anything like that, but I just loved color. Like that was pretty much it. And my favorite thing to do is what I'm calling art glooping, which basically I would just take gloops or like chunks of paint and just like smear it all over the page and just ultimately come up with a color gradient. So fast forward into becoming a student and now a worker of corporate America. I noticed I'm definitely a paper and pencil and agenda planner kind of person. Like that's just how I take my notes. Every time I try to type notes, I just like don't retain anything. So yeah. Anyways, so I thought why not take my inner child calling of art glooping and my adulthood needs of note taking and putting it together and making some stationery, which leads me to the point of this whole vlog, which is yes, we are designing stationery and I hope to make like memo pads or like notepads, that kind of thing. So in this video, I will be doing more of the designing process and just like learning as I go and then doing a test print to see if this is something that I would like to commit to. And my goal is to continue these studio vlogs until I just start an Etsy shop. So let's manifest it. Let's put it out there. And if not, it will just be on my list of failures and I will take the L. Okay, the mini story time rant is over. Let's get started and let's get into designing. Ironically, on my brainstorming day, it was storming like crazy, but it gave me an opportunity to get all cozy and just sketch out a couple of designs I had in mind. I knew I wanted to do color gradients, so here I am just making patches of different blues and then using the Gaussian blur effect to create a gradient. So the color combo here is actually inspired by the opening of the singer Taemin's music video titled Criminal. I really like the bright red text and the contrast it gave, so I just drew inspiration from it. I wrote out Criminal in the background and just readjusted it just to see what it looked like in the background so it wasn't just a plain color gradient. I don't know, just decided to give it a try, but to be honest, I wasn't really feeling this 100%. Something fell off with it. It was either the color saturation or the oval shape in the middle, or I'm not really sure. So I took a break to regain some creative energy. After talking it out with a friend, I had to rethink my color palette and what kind of vibe I was really going for, and then I finally got it. I didn't live vlog me doing it because I just wasn't expecting it. I thought it was gonna be another brainstorming session kind of day. Instead of writing something in the background like I did in the previous day, I wanted to add some text in the bottom corner of the notepad. So here I wrote, "The universe is yours," as a positive affirmation. Not gonna lie, I didn't do much on day three because my job was kicking my butt. All I did was change the little Saturn drawing I had into a heart Saturn to make it more my style. I also had the idea to make the positive affirmations into a collection, so I wanted to add different gradients of colors and affirmations to pair with it. I'm calling it the Yours collection for now, but this just felt right and I was just so relieved that it was all coming together. So the other notepads I want to include in this collection will be The Universe is Yours, The World is Yours, and The Future is Yours. On day 4, I wanted to start The World is Yours notepad with a earthy theme gradient. But since I'm not that great with color palettes, I went on Pinterest for some inspiration. Interestingly enough, the blue and green hair photos on Pinterest were the exact colors I was looking for. Especially the one I took a screenshot of, which by the way, I'll link in the description for credit. But yeah, I didn't really use the colors exactly. I added some brightness or saturation depending on what it looked like on the canvas. But it's a great way to start learning about color theory and what goes with what. Also, I realized a lot later after finishing the color gradient for the pink notepad that I haven't been drawing to scale. So the canvas or screen that I had been working on was a 2048 by 2048 pixel screen, which means that this would print out to 15 inches. So this green and blue notepad, I first did a quick measurement and cut out to see what I wanted my notepads to be, either like 3 or 4 inches, and the 4 by 4 inches ended up being the winner. So for the green and blue notepad, I made sure to work on a 4 by 4 inch measure notepad so then it would print to scale. But the issue I faced here was that the quality of the canvas actually got worse by doing that, especially when I was trying to write. So then I just, you know, took it to YouTube to find a solution. Luckily, I did find a solution, and it is all in the DPI settings. So DPI means dots per inch. So the higher count you have, the higher quality it will be. But based on what I've learned, increasing the DPI means that you will also have to work with less layers on your artwork. But in my case, this just works out fine. So while Googling best settings for Procreate and all of that, I discovered the color model terms RGB, which stands for red, green, blue, and CMYK, which stands for cyan, magenta, yellow, and key, which is actually just referring to the color black. It is suggested that if you're printing out something that you should be using CMYK according to the internet, but of course, without doing a test print or anything, I went ahead and just started all over again on my designs, but with the CMYK color palette, which looked very different from RGB. After I finished two of my notepad designs, I finally figured that I should just print them out just to see what the situation is. Also, to explain the lines that are being printed out, yeah, my printer's broken, so it does that. But I thought I would just work with what I have now before committing to buying a new printer and other equipment, so yeah. So, here's what we got. Here are the pink notepads in both different sizes and color palettes. The left is the CMYK color model and in a 4-inch size print. And on the right, we have the RGB color model at 2048 pixels. For the green notepads, I had a 3-inch version that was RGB on the right and a CMYK color model with the text included on the left at 4 inches. To be honest, both of these kind of look the same to me. And overall, I honestly was really pleased with how the prints turned out. I'm so happy with these. Okay, I'm like really just so happy with like the print. Like I'm just so happy that this did not come out blurry. It looks so clear. It looks like I just wrote on it. It honestly looks even better. I'm just really happy with that because I was like, honestly, my main concern. My second concern was sizing. So we figured out that this like sizing works. I did 4 inches by 4 inches on Procreate. So I was able to size out like this and not like, you know, be blurry or something. And I think the whole DPI making that higher really helped. And the second thing that I was worried about was the color palette. I thought you would have to do the CMYK. And I really think it might be like a printer thing. You have to make sure your printer can like handle either RGB or CMYK. So yeah, seems like my printer was fine. Also, speaking of my printer, these lines, just to like reiterate, my printer is broken. It just has these lines and it's like a family printer, you know, we share it. So like we never bother to fix it because we don't use color that often and the black and white print works fine. There's like no lines. So just to explain like why it's like this, but this is not the way I wanted. But yeah, I really like the color. I think it's really pretty. And I just finally feel like just seeing these prints makes me feel like this is like a possible project. And I'm really just happy. Like I feel like I could actually like write notes on these. There's like obviously some tweaks I want to do with like color palettes and like maybe making it a little bit lighter, but I don't know. This is cute. I want to write notes on this. I don't know about you, but I would use this. So I feel like there's a possibility here that this might not be a fail, but anyways, we will see. So like my vision here is really that I want people to feel confident when they write on my stationery. Like I know a lot of people say that when they like clothing or makeup or jewelry, like apparel in general, but like why not stationery? Like I want people to walk into their meeting with a cool notepad, taking their notes, and I want people to look at them like, wow, that's cool, you know? Like, why not? And like, I just don't want people to feel boring when they take notes. Like, I want to bring some excitement and color into their maybe mundane world of school or work. So yeah, that is the plan because I want that. So yeah, that is my overall long-term vision and goal for this potential Etsy shop and my stationery that I will be designing. And we'll just see where this goes in Studio Vlog 2. I hope to really just make this a more tangible product and really make it and get the supplies and stuff like that. So be sure to subscribe so you don't miss it. And you can follow along with me on this journey and watch me either fail or succeed at this. So it will be exciting either way. I hope. Okay, anyways, I'm gonna end the vlog because it's time to end this vlog. Until next time, stay healthy and happy, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye!